was a kid, there was a show on Nickelodeon called Double Dare. It is where two teams compete to win cash and prizes by answering trivia questions and doing physical challenges. Usually the physical challenges were messy stunts and all that goofy shit. The show began in 1986 and went on to 1993 on its first run, and it had a revival in 2000 and then a second revival in 2018, which still continues. The well-known host, Mark Summers, who later on went on to work for the Food Network on the show Unwrapped, which talked about candy and all that stuff. I think he was talking about a variety of food, but I watched it a few times. It wasn't a bad show. Kind of interesting how something is made. He was the host. He did a pretty damn good job on Double Dare. And of course, there were shows like special editions of Double Dare, like Super Sloppy Double Dare, Family Double Dare, and so on. In 1988, a video game made its way onto the scene, which was developed and published by Game Tech and was originally released on the MS-DOS operating system and Commodore 64. It was later re-released in 1990 for the NES and was developed by Rare and published by Game Tech. In this review, I'm just going to check out the NES version of the game, and funny enough, I've never played this game until doing this review, so this should be quite interesting. Now, you can play Double Dare with one or two players, so if you have a friend, you can do that, but single player will have you against a computer opponent. And before the game starts, you enter a team name and select from four male and female avatars. Whatever you choose, your teammate will be the opposite gender. When it comes to this video game, it's pretty similar to the TV show. You start out by doing some sort of physical challenge, either throwing bananas at a gorilla, bowling, catching cakes, and more. You will answer 10 questions in two different rounds and you get money. If you win, you move on to the obstacle course, which has you using the D-pad left or right and up and down, and you must grab the flag. The questions you answer vary from a variety of topics: history, entertainment, sports, and more. I guess you could say this is a trivia game with a little bit of action in sections to it, which is kind of interesting. The graphics for Double Dare are not bad for an 8-bit game. When it comes to the physical challenges and all of that, it looks fine. Obviously, it's supposed to be the set of the show and all that. And when it comes to answering questions, you have your avatars that you choose, and then you have Mark Summers in the middle. While it doesn't necessarily look like Mark Summers, I won't say it's a flaw. I totally understand why the game looks how it does. The game doesn't glitch or flicker. At least I never ran into any. It could be a lot worse than this, that's for sure. When it comes to the music, it's all right. Could be worse. Nothing mind-blowing fits this type of game. It's not thrown together trash or anything, which is definitely nice. There's music during the physical challenges and, of course, the title screen and so on. When it comes to sound effects, well, nothing to really complain about. Nothing amazing, but there are some, ranging from choosing your answers to the sound of the timer ticking down, and of course when you're doing physical challenges and all that, there's sound effects there. When it comes to the controls, when answering questions, it's very simple to do. Doing some of the challenges, though, it's a little confusing. You have to stop the speed of how hard you're going to throw something or whatever, and you need to stop at one angle. You would think it would be all done on the D-pad, left for the speed, right for the angle, but it's the D-pad and B button, and you have to actually time it just right, which can be tough. The game is still playable and all that, and it's all about good reaction time. I just wish it wasn't as confusing at first. But that's okay. If you have a brain, you're able to figure it out. Double Dare on the NES is not a bad game. It's nothing special either. It's really kind of hard to get into a game that is based off of a game show. Granted, I'm not saying it's a piece of shit, but it's not something I'm going to spend hours playing. If I had a friend over, it might be more enjoyable. The gameplay is alright, the graphics are not bad, the music and sound effects are okay, but nothing special. The controls are a little confusing when it comes to the layout right at first, but once you get the hang of it, at least when it comes to the physical challenges and so on, they're not horrible. Like I said, the game is very much playable. This is one of those games that's just there. It's something to play every once in a while if you're really bored and want to play something different. If you like game show video games, you might find this to be an amazing game. If not, you might want to skip it. If you want a copy of Double Dare, it's 36% rare, and prices on eBay range from $440, $14.99, $23.99, $11.24, $14.95, $7.50, $19.85, $17.99, and prices in between. Really not bad, a little expensive on the higher prices. I think $5 to maybe $10 isn't bad, but I'm surprised this game is not higher on the rarity scale. You know, this seems like one of them games that could be 75% rare because either they didn't make a lot of copies and nobody really bought it, so what's out there could be hard to find, but it's not, surprisingly. There are no other Double Dare games, and that's probably a good thing. With that being said, I haven't watched the new show, and I really have no reason to as well. It's one of them game shows that was fun back in the day to watch as a kid, and that's it. I hope you enjoyed this review of Double Dare on the NES. Thanks for watching.